Hey, all you YouTubers out there. I've got this Nutone or Broan ceiling, bathroom ceiling fan. It has a heater and a light. Control looks like this. And when I put the heat on, I can hear it humming, but the blower's not running. So I'm gonna dig into this and see whether the motor has failed or see exactly what the problem is. Well, I've got the unit open. I know exactly what the problem is. It's like the blower wheel. It's the one, this one right here. This is the blower that has the heater on it. And looks like the two mounting screws that hold the motor to the blower housing have loosened. And therefore the blower wheel is jammed up against the blower housing. So I'm gonna remove the whole assembly, take it down, tighten the nuts up, and it looks like it'll be good as new, because when I push the motor into the correct position and turn the switch on, the blower runs, the heater runs, works great. So I'm gonna pull it out, tighten them up, and I'll show you what that looks like in a minute. So I have the heater blower unit out of the complete assembly, and you can see right here, this is all loose. There's just two mounting screws, one here and one here, and it's loose. Because it's loose, the blower wheel is jammed up against the blower housing. And if you look right down inside, this is going to be really difficult to shoot with my poor camera, but there are two nuts in there. There's one right there. It's right where this mounting screw and this mounting screw go through. There are two nuts on the inside of the housing. Tighten those two nuts up, and I think this will be repaired and good as new. What I've done is I removed three screws, one, two, three. I'm going to lift this housing off, this side of the housing off. And inside is really hard to shoot with an iPad. With the housing off, I can remove the blower wheel. It's probably a set screw. Yep, there it is. Remove that blower wheel set screw. Pull the blower wheel off and tighten the two nuts behind it. Well, I have the blower wheel off, as you can see right here. Move the blower wheel, and these are the two nuts that need to be tightened. And once those are tightened, I think my repair will be complete. Well, my repair is complete, and I've actually tested it by simply plugging this in over there. Do not do that unless you really know what you're doing here, because you could get electrocuted, right? Because this is an exposed heating coil. So if you don't know what's live and what's not live, just go ahead and put the unit all the way back in and test it in the complete exhaust fan assembly, and do not plug this in again if you don't know what you're doing. I take no responsibility if you electrocute yourself or burn your house down. So I did tighten those nuts up, but before I did that, I put two lock washers on there. One lock washer on each bolt. I like to repair things only once. I'll never have to worry about that loosening up again. All my repairs are complete, so let me turn it on. Let's see if it works. Beautiful. Fan's running, and I've got hot air. So my worst fear was put aside. I was very concerned that I had a burned out motor. I was going to have to replace the motor, but didn't have to replace anything. Added two lock washers, a little bit of time, and it's as good as new. So let's give it a final test. It's a regular exhaust fan. That's the heater. Night light and the regular light. So there you go. Give me a thumbs up if you found this at all helpful, or if you liked it. Thanks for watching.